حي على الفلاح.
The story of the people of the Sabt, which is Sarray. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in the Quran al-Kareem. The Jews who were living in the outskirts of Medina, O Muhammad asked them about the town that lived by the sea.
These were from the Bani Israel. They had a village by the sea and they used to take their livelihood from fishing. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, they had become used to disobeying Allah. In other words, they had started to do haram things. If you do bad things, Allah will send upon you a trial and a tribulation. Evil has appeared on the face of the land and the sea because of what men's hands have put forth. Allah says, thus did we make a trial of them, for they were given to transgression. Allah sent them a test. Now, what a test this is. Imagine this is a village whose livelihood comes from fishing. And we know that in the Sharia that Allah gave to Musa, the Jews were prohibited, and still, you know, that's what they follow. They were prohibited from doing any work on the Sabbath. They're not allowed to do any work on the Sabbath at all. Every day you're allowed to fish, there are no fish in the sea, nothing. But on the one day, when you're not allowed to touch the fish, you're not allowed to go fishing, the fish appear in the sea as if they, and they are so many, they're jumping out of the water. You would say, this is a test from Allah. No, no, not these people. What did they do?
So what happened here? One day, a man thought of a trick. Allah Azza wa Jal forbids us to work or to set up our nets on Sarray. So what he said to himself, why don't I set up a net before Sarray comes and I leave my net there all the way till Sarray ends, and then after Sarray ends, I could go and capture the fish or catch the fish that's out there stuck in the net. By the time Sarray ends, a large number of fish has been caught in that net. So he comes and he finds a large number of fish that he takes back home. So one day, while he was cooking his fish, the neighbors start to smell the nice smell of the cooked fish. So they came and asked him, where did you get this fish from? So he told them about his trick. So some people start to take it on board. And now this trick starts to be widespread amongst the children of Israel, the people of that town. Now the people of that town saw this trick. Who are you trying to trick? Are you trying to trick Allah Azza wa Jal? Are you playing a game on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And then you go and take all the fish that's caught in that net and you say to yourself, you didn't do anything on Sarray. This is a trick, this is a game.
They thought they were being really clever. So now in this village, there were three groups of people that we can identify. So there is one group saying to another group, why do you preach to a people whom Allah will destroy or visit with a terrible punishment? So there was a group of preachers. Group number one is breaking the Sabbath. Group number two is preaching. They're going to the Sabbath breakers. They're saying, fear Allah. Don't do this thing. This is wrong. And then there's another group. And this other group, they're not breaking the Sabbath. And they're saying to the preachers, why do you bother with these ones whom Allah is going to destroy them? So we can see three groups. The preachers, the breakers, and the mind your own business. I go to the masjid, I do my duty, I mind my own business. When they find people preaching, why are you bothering? Allah's going to destroy them.
We spoke to them, we admonished them, we tried to turn them back from disobeying Allah. They did not listen to us. Ya Allah, we did our best. We did our best. Over the course of time, those who obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and went against those who disobeyed Allah, they continued to remind those who disobeyed Allah to stop disobeying Allah. But those who disobeyed Allah refused to listen to those who obeyed Allah, and refuse to listen to those who are trying to stop them from disobeying Allah. So they continue to transgress, and every Sarray they'll set up their nets before Sarray enters, and they'll keep their nets there until Sarray is over, and then they'll go and get their nets. By then they'll have caught so much fish in there, and then they'll go and eat that fish, sell it and use it for whatever they want to use it for. However, those who obeyed Allah continued to fish on the other days that Allah allowed them to fish in. They continued to fish on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. When Saturday enters, they do not fish, they do not engage in any sort of fishing. They stay at home worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal. But then over the course of time, these people start to become more distant. They start to become so distant from one another that those who obeyed Allah, they encircled themselves and they built around them a fortress. So they wanted to divide themselves from those who disobeyed Allah Azza wa Jal. And those who disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were also living in their own fortress. So now in one town, it was divided to two small towns. One small town of those who disobeyed Allah, the other small town of those who obeyed Allah, and those who did not support those in disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal, even though they did not speak out against him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, until time where they forgot and neglected the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we saved those who feed us, and we had punished those who disobeyed us a severe punishment because of their disobedience. So Allah Azza wa Jal let those who were disobeying him to continue disobeying him. And this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's way. When someone disobeys Allah, Allah does not punish them then and there. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lets go of them and lets them and gives them the opportunity for them to repent to him, for them to go back to him. But it reached to that time and limit where Allah would just destroy them. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did. He destroyed them. How did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy them? One night, everyone went back to their fortress. Those who obeyed Allah and those who did not disobey Allah but did not go against those who disobeyed Allah, well, they were together in one fortress. They entered that fortress. Those who disobeyed Allah slept that night in their own fortress. The next morning, those who obeyed Allah and those who were with them, they came out of their fortress, and during the day they were waiting for their cousins, and some of them their own brothers, some of them their own siblings, some of them they come from the same family and tribe. They were waiting for them to come out of their fortress. But as time went past, and then it's more than midday, they did not see anyone come out of their fortress. It's like a dead fortress. What happened to them? So they went to their fortress, and amazingly to see in front of them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent upon them a curse and a punishment, that Allah deformed them and turned them all to despised apes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned them all to apes and monkeys. In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that he turned them into apes and pigs. These people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not allow any offsprings come out of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give them any offsprings or any progeny. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them all 3 days after Allah deformed them. Allah says, and you already know about those who transgressed on the Sarray day. Those who went beyond the limit, and those who disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who did wrong by themselves on Sarray, when Allah told them not to fish, and they wanted to trick. They wanted to trick who? They wanted to trick Allah Azza wa Jal. So they went to their forts, they saw their own cousins and relatives, those who disobeyed Allah. We made this punishment, a severe punishment, for what they did, for the wrong deeds they committed. And it is a lesson for those who fear Allah. Don't you ever think you could trick Allah? And don't play games with the deen of Allah. We made this as a lesson for those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a punishment for those who disobeyed Allah, and a lesson for those who fear Allah azza wa jal. And it's also been narrated that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the other group, and Allah azza wa jal, Allah revived the deen and the iman amongst that town, where Islam continued to revive until they decided to distort their religion generations after that.